We'll start with the welcome address with Mr. VK Kanjlia, please.
A very good morning, ladies and gentlemen. At the outset, I congratulate Mr. A.G. Pillai, President, India Smart Grid Forum, for his initiative to have a very important session on smart water, and thank him for giving me an opportunity to deliver the welcome address. On the occasion of smart water session, it is my pleasure to welcome my co-speakers, Shri Pratap Patode, Founder and Director, Smart Cities Council of India, and Mr. Arnab Ghosh, CEO, Council of Energy, Environment and Water. I heartily extend a warm welcome to all the speakers, invitees, and the participants. We just had a wonderful presentation on advanced strategies to deliver a full smart water solution by Mr. Tom Welch. I congratulate him for an excellent presentation. This presentation has provided us a good platform to begin this session. Today's program is divided into three sessions, wherein the experts shall be sharing their experiences. The major issues concerning water resources in India can be broadly classified into issues of water availability and quality for use in the domestic, industrial, and service sectors, etc. The present water storage capacity in the country is approximately 253 billion cubic meter. Per capita availability in India is only 200 cubic meter against 2,000 to 3,000 in Australia, Brazil, and USA. In China, it is more than 400 cubic meter. Therefore, all possible storage sites need to be fully harnessed in the form of multiple projects or storage-based hydropower projects to store and preserve water derived from the rainfall. Storage-based utilization of surface water can produce the stress on groundwater exploitation and ensure water quality. However, due to issues associated with environment and forest, R&R, and land acquisition, it is becoming highly difficult to construct storage-based water resources projects. The only alternative to us is to utilize the available water resources smartly and economically. Therefore, this session on smart water is very important and timely. Another serious problem is the lack of maintenance in water supply and sanitation, leading to contamination of groundwater sources in most of the cities and towns today. The main cause of contamination of groundwater and surface water is the improper discharge of sewage. More than half of the cities have no sewage treatment facilities. Treatment and use of municipal water provides an opportunity for not only environmental rehabilitation, but also meeting the increasing needs of different economic sectors. It's a critical component of any sustainable solution for water and wastewater management in India. We must begin to learn that we will have to reuse every drop of sewage water. Even if 80% of urban wastewater could be treated by 2030, there would be a total volume of around 17 billion cubic meter per year, equivalent to almost 75% of projected industrial demand in 2025, and almost a quarter of the total projected drinking water requirement in the country. Incorporating smart water technologies allows water providers to minimize non-revenue water by finding leaks quickly and even predictively using real-time SCADA data and comparing that to model network simulations. A medium-sized city with 100 million gallons per day of produced water loses about 25% of such water. In India, the first city to take the lead is Nagpur, Maharashtra. Now included in this smart cities list, it has a population of about over 2.5 million people, and the first city of this size in the country to outsource water supply to a private operator under the PPP model for 25 years. The project included management of the entire water cycle from production, treatment, transport, storage, and delivery to the customer's tap. It involved replacement of over 3 lakh house service connections, rehabilitation of treatment facilities, service reservoirs, and pipeline. So from the presentation we have and the situation on ground, it's apparently clear that we have plenty of water, but due to lack of storage facilities, improper utilization, and wastage, so we are not able to meet our water requirement. And if we see in the future what's going to happen with the increase in population, increase in the lifestyle, and more urbanization, the shortage of water is going to increase. The one alternative is to improve the storage facilities, but due to various problems, it's becoming difficult to take up. More and more projects involving storage. Therefore, the only practical option is to reuse the wastewater as well as to minimize the and economically use the available water. I am sure these steps will be very useful in improving the availability of water to the citizens of the country. I wish great success of this program on smart water, and thank you all for your kind attention. Thank you.